OpenAI just dropped two new groundbreaking models that will forever change how we build and think about AI agents today. In fact, this release is so huge that OpenAI is not even calling them models themselves, they're calling them
AI systems.
And everyone on YouTube just seems to be comparing benchmarks when no benchmarks that we have today can possibly capture the whole potential of this release. So in this video, I'm going to break down why these are no longer even AI models, what AI systems really are, and of course, tell you how you can prepare to build the next generation of AI agents right now. So let's get started. To understand what an AI system really is, we first need to understand what a system is in general. And as defined in one of my favorite books by Donella Meadows, Thinking in Systems, a system is a set of interconnected things that together produce their own behavior over time. Essentially, what this means is that a system is a group of elements where the whole is bigger than the sum of its parts. This is a very key thing to remember because we will return to this later. But what else is a system? Well, it's pretty much everything around you. Your home is a system, your phone is a system, your business is a system, and you yourself as a human being are also a system. And all systems have a few key components, which if you understand now, will make your life a lot easier because it will give you a whole new lens through which you can understand the world. So those components are elements, interconnections, and purpose. Each system is a set of elements interconnected together in such a way that achieves something. So for example, a thermostat in your home is a system. It has a goal of keeping a temperature at a certain level. It has a few elements like the temperature sensor, AC, and the windows outside. All of these elements work together in a feedback loop to keep temperature constant. So for example, whenever the temperature outside goes up, like it's around 40 degrees Celsius right now outside in Dubai, so my AC kicks in to bring the temperature back to a comfortable level. This is a perfect example of a feedback loop in action. This feedback loop is absolutely crucial for any system because this is what makes the system behave in a certain way. This is what all system thinkers look at first in a system because it allows them to understand how the system is going to behave over time. And if we look at all the previous large language models released before, this feedback loop simply was not there. All previous models would simply take some inputs and then produce some outputs and maybe call some tools in between, and that's it. As an AI agency building real production-ready AI agents for businesses ourselves, this has been one of the biggest challenges for us from the very start. Before, models were simply not able to reflect upon their own actions. So our agents would sometimes simply stop short and fail to complete their tasks even when they were on the right track. Even with Gemini 2.5 and O3 Mini, we've had these issues. All reasoning models before O3 and O4 Mini were simply not trained to reason over tool calls. They were trained to reason over text, over the inputs that the user provides to this model, but not over tools. And to fix that, before, we would need to add more agents that would supervise those other agents below and would reflect on what they've done for them and then tell the other agents what to do next. All that simply because this crucial feedback loop was missing. But with O4 Mini and O3, it's finally there. These are the first models that, as quoted from OpenAI's blog posts, were specifically trained to use tools through reinforcement learning, teaching them not just how to use tools, but to reason about when to use them. And this is why these models can execute up to 600 tool calls in a sequence. Yes, 600 tool calls. Greg Brockman casually mentioned this at the beginning.
We are going to be releasing two models, O3 and O4 Mini. It's like we haven't really seen anything like this. And the thing that's really amazing about these models is that they're not just models, they're really AI systems. We've trained them to use tools, which is not something that we had done with our previous reasoning models. they actually use these tools in their chain of thought as they're trying to solve a hard problem. For example, we've seen O3 use like 600 tool calls in a row trying to solve a really hard task.
This is the biggest breakthrough that they were able to achieve, and I don't think that many people really understand the true implications of that, which is something that we will of course get to very soon. But first, how were they able to do this? Well, to explain that, I've made a Figma file with a couple diagrams here. So now let's jump into Figma. Here is how a standard agent would execute their tasks. As you can see, it's pretty straightforward. So an agent typically comes up with a plan and then executes all of the tasks using special tools sequentially. So the agent will simply execute all of the actions one by one, and that's it. And then typically, if there is something that happens midway, like for example, there is something that goes wrong here, the agent will never go this way because the agent can't reason over tool calls. Again, those standard agents can only reason over the messages, over the inputs by the user, not the tools, which is why the agent typically would not be able to correct its course. But an agent based on O3 or O4 mini acts different. So as you can see, an agent based on O3 doesn't just execute a task in the same way as planned. The agent based on O3 or O4 mini can actually think after every single action and then select the proper path accordingly. So this is the key difference here. As you can see, the agent can automate significantly more complex workflows because it's no longer constrained to this initial path that was planned in the beginning. This means that this agent can automate pretty much any workflow in the world, especially if it can call 600 tools in a sequence. Additionally, this also has another implication on how the agent works in general. So this is a standard GPT agent where, as you can see, we have a few components. Like for example, we have the model, we have knowledge and tools. And now let's take a look at the reasoning agent with O3 or O4 mini. So with reasoning, there is one additional feedback loop right here. And although it doesn't seem like a big difference, it actually makes a very large impact because now the agent doesn't just execute your tools according to your task and then return the result. The agent can actually think about every single tool call and then execute further tools as necessary. So although this feedback loop is really small, what it allows the agent to do is loop by itself. So now the agent no longer needs inputs from the human or any feedback from the human to keep going. It can actually keep going by itself forever. It can get some outputs from the tools, think about them, and then plan the next actions accordingly until the task is fully satisfied. So this is the real breakthrough that OpenAI has made. Now these AI systems can finally utilize all three elements together: reasoning, tool calls, and modalities, which are image and text inputs, in a continuous reinforcement feedback loop. This is why these systems are so much bigger than the sum of their parts. And although, as I said before, benchmarks cannot fully show the whole potential of these models, you can clearly see this trend on AMI 2025, which is a very competitive math benchmark. It took OpenAI years to get to 70-80% on this benchmark, but now they've been able to ace it with 99.5% accuracy in just 8 months. And they've been able to completely close this gap by simply providing O4 mini with tools. So they didn't even build a new model, they just added tools to O4 mini and it completely closed the gap. So as you can see, the jump from O3 mini at 86.5% to O4 mini at 93.4% is around 46% improvement, meaning that they closed the gap by 46%. But the jump from O4 mini to O4 mini with tools is 93% improvement. So they closed the gap by 93%. So with no other changes, simply by adding tools to this model, they were able to double the percentage improvement on this benchmark. This is exactly why these AI systems are, again, so much bigger than the sum of their parts. And this has huge implications for the world of AI agents, as you might guess. First of all, it's exponential from here. With this release, OpenAI has just basically solved math. But what else is based on math? It's large language models. So now they will be able to build new AI systems like this faster. Agents will finally become reliable. Currently, one of the biggest bottlenecks preventing the mass adoption of AI agents is their reliability. And although the new reasoning models are still not perfect, the fact that they can reason after every single tool call means that they can better understand and correct their own mistakes, just like humans would. Agents will tell you what to do, because these models are reasoners and they can generate novel and unique insights. You no longer have to tell them exactly what they need to do. Instead, they will think, they will reason about the provided data and tools, and then they will tell you what to do. So instead of writing extremely long prompts, now all you need to do is simply provide them with access to your internal systems, data, and send a few goals. That's it. They will then find the best path to achieve your goals by themselves. No human can possibly keep track of more than 600 tool calls to complete a given task. Workflow automation platforms are basically done. So, since these agents can literally reason about the best path to complete a given task, I believe that they will also be able to design incredibly complicated workflows by themselves that would have taken you days to design yourself on platforms like Zapier or Make. Next, agents will evolve over time. With the reasoning and self-reflection like this, I believe that agents will soon be able to adjust their own instructions and tools to make their own workflows even more dynamic. If there is something that they can do, they will reason about it and adjust their own architecture accordingly. And the biggest implication is that AI agents will be able to run for days. As I showed before, agents no longer have to rely on inputs provided by the user. They can reason after every single tool call, which means that they can now run for much longer. They will now be able to execute incredibly sophisticated tasks that require days for them to finish. Okay, now let's discuss a couple of limitations, and then I'll tell you how to prepare for building the next generation of AI agents with these models. So the first limitation is that sometimes these models still do very dumb mistakes that a human would never do. This is expected with the O4 mini model because it's smaller. The hallucinations for this model are actually significantly greater than for O3. And secondly, at the time of recording this video, tool calling is still not available in the API. OpenAI said that they need 2 more weeks to release tool calling. So for now, we can't really leverage them as AI systems. We can only leverage them as AI models. So now here are my best tips and how to prepare for building AI agents with these models. The first and the most important advice I can give you is take initiative. It's clear that the implementation part will soon be completely outsourced to AI systems. Even right now, they can build incredible apps just from a single prompt. But it's still crazy to me that so many people have access to these systems in their pockets and they don't even take time to explore them or at least send the first prompt. So in a year or two, I believe that you will be able to build literally anything just from a single prompt. So it's the people who take initiative today that will achieve the most in the future. Next, start building agents right now. Do not wait until tool calling is available for these models in the API. Build an agent for your personal tasks, for your daily work, for a business or maybe even a company that you work for, if possible, because no business right now utilizes even the capabilities of previous models to their full extent. And I believe that in a few years, every business will employ more AI agents than humans. So if you don't know how to get started, keep in mind that you're not alone. We have a community completely for free and a platform where you can find all the support and tools that you need. Unlike all other communities that were built by people who have never deployed a single agent in production, we have real AI agent developers, exclusive courses, and weekly Q&A calls that I'm personally hosting myself completely for free. Okay, the next tip is know which model to use and when. I know it can be really confusing, especially with OpenAI's naming, but you need to know which model to use. And to do that, you need to consider both the capabilities of these models and the costs. Right now, O4 Mini is about 5 times cheaper than O3 and 2-3 times cheaper than Gemini, with almost the same performance on benchmarks. Although, as I said before, do not look at the benchmarks. So for now, O4 Mini is my recommended model for AI agents. However, it doesn't mean that you should only be using reasoning models for every single agent. Just like in real companies, we need agents who can just go and implement things without too much thinking. In agencies composed of AI agents, we also need those implementation models without thinking, like GPT-4o and 4.1. So if the task is clearly scoped and is straightforward, then simply use the new GPT-4.1 because they're extremely cheap and fast and can get stuff done easily when provided a clear plan. Regarding O3, only use it for mission critical tasks where the margin for error is very low and you need to prevent all hallucinations. One more question, which I'm sure you guys are asking, is this AGI or not? Because of course on Twitter, there are already people who are saying that yes, this is absolutely AGI, and people who are saying that no, it's not even close. And in my opinion, these AI systems are not AGI by default, but we can make them AGI even right now. If we define AGI as a system capable of performing most tasks better than humans, then before it can actually do that, we need to provide that system with all the necessary tools, knowledge, and instructions on how to complete those tasks. So although these AI systems can call up to 600 tools in a sequence, it doesn't mean that they can use 600 different tools at the same time. At most, I suppose it would be around 20 tools for O4 Mini and 30-40 tools for O3. This is not nearly enough to complete most human general tasks, obviously. So what this means is that we need a multi-agent system. We need to build agents, each specialized for their own specific tasks with their own sets of tools and instructions, just like in real human organizations. And if we all do that for each specific industry and for every business worldwide, then yes, we will have an AGI. So even with the current capabilities of these AI systems, I believe that we can all together create a real AGI. We just need to take initiative and start building agents in our own specific industries right now. So if you want to learn more how exactly people are doing that, for example, how Chase scaled an AI sales agent team to over $50,000 a month, I recommend watching this video next. Thanks, bye.